What's in a kiss? In the previous episode, we decoded the body language of lip kisses. And while kisses on the face are often more romantic or platonic, they can be a precursor for so much more, revealing your kissing partner's intentions, attraction, and perhaps even their level of commitment. Here's your kiss by kiss guide to the body language of face kisses. So what does that kiss on the face really mean? When we're decoding the body language of kissing, it's important to remember that each kiss can mean different things depending on the level of eye contact and touch and how close your groins and torsos get. As a general rule, the more attracted we are, the closer we'll try and get and the more eye contact and touch we'll see. Let's start with the forehead kiss. The tender forehead kiss can be platonic or romantic and nurturing, depending on the position of your heart window and groins. This kiss says, "I care about you. Put your trust in me," and allows you to lower your head and nestle in as a sign of trust and vulnerability. A tender forehead kiss or caress can be at the same time nurturing and arousing, as touch messages received from trigeminal nerves in your forehead are processed by your brain. A forehead kiss where your torso and groins touch or almost touch communicates protectiveness and lust, whereas distance between your torsos and groins might indicate a more platonic, brotherly-sisterly kiss. The earlobe kiss is often seen in couples who've already been physically intimate and suggests a certain degree of emotional and physical intimacy. Now, while earlobe kisses can be a major turn-off for some people, for others they're super pleasurable, stimulating the erogenous zones. In these people, stimulation of the three cranial nerves through kissing, blowing, biting, and gentle licking of the earlobes can be particularly arousing. Have you ever wondered why light and feathery neck kisses feel so good? The neck is one of the body's pleasurable erogenous zones, brimming with super sensitive nerve endings. But while exposing the neck indicates attraction, it also requires vulnerability. So take it slow and listen to what their body is trying to tell you. The butterfly kiss is a tender kiss that indicates a level of trust and an emotional and physical bond. Much like the Inuit or Eskimo kiss, this kiss is more about smell, essentially breathing your partner in as you flutter your eyelashes against your partner's. Now, if you're still in the pre-kiss stage, a kiss on the nose can be a playful way of increasing intimacy and indicating interest while testing the waters. It says, "I'm playing it safe, but I so want to kiss you." For those in a relationship, this kiss is a loving and affectionate gesture that says, "You're beautiful." A kiss on the hair or head can be both a sign of affection and protectiveness or a warning sign that things aren't okay in a relationship. In a healthy relationship, kissing on the head or hair is a nurturing gesture that indicates a close emotional bond. It says, "I'm here for you." However, in relationships marked by conflict and little emotional or physical intimacy or support, this kiss can feel condescending and can be a sign of an imbalance of status and power. The Eskimo kiss, otherwise known as the Kunik kiss or nose kiss, is often seen between parents and their young children or couples in love. This affectionate and often playful kiss involves rubbing your noses together and breathing one another in. On the other hand, a kiss on the shoulder is a sign of both emotional and physical intimacy. It says, "I'm here for you and I want to be close to you." A cheek kiss is often seen as a platonic greeting and a friendly way of saying hello in many cultures. However, a cheek kiss can also reveal someone's intentions and how they feel about you. While a quick peck on the cheek says, I like you as a friend, a cheek kiss that lingers or has lips that part can be a sign that they really like you, but respect you and your personal space. The lingering cheek kiss allows them to get into your personal space, to receive non-verbal smell or olfactory cues, and to test the waters. It says, I respect you, I really want to kiss you, but I'm not sure how to proceed.